All right, what is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Backyard Sim Racing. I haven't been haven't put any videos up in a little while, and the reason why is because I have been just spending a lot of time on this game. For a while now, I've been anticipating a new game that is coming out on February 3rd. I don't know if you guys have heard of it or not. If you're watching just because you watch sim racing, you probably haven't heard of it just because it's not a sim racing title. However, it is a simulation. On February 3rd, American Truck Simulator is coming out, and that game is created by the same makers who make this game, which is Euro Truck Simulator, which is an award-winning simulation that, believe it or not, I had just never tried out. But because I'm very, very excited about running the American Truck Simulator, I wanted to try this one out because from what I hear, they're going to be very similar in the way they play and it just in how the all the menus work and stuff like it's basically going to be the same game as Euro Truck Simulator because that was such a success, just placed in another part of the world. So I think what I'm going to do, and you guys give me some feedback whether or not it's something that you want to see, but I think I'm going to do some. I hate to even use the word let's plays because this is not a let's play, really not a let's play channel, but that's really what this is. It'll just be some commentary and doing some missions and stuff like that while I drive around. It seems to be a success on a lot of people's channels, so I figured I would try it too. And like I said, give me some feedback. But I'm gonna go ahead and crank up the truck, and I'll get to talking while we're driving here, and hopefully that'll work out. I do have this spanning across my NVIDIA surround. I went into the config files and worked out the monitor bezels and the field of view and all that. And I know you can't see a lot of the dashboard and things like that, but I actually prefer it like this because this is realistic field of views. This is what I like. So we're going to fire her up. I also have a dash on my phone, and I actually have purchased in-game a Mercedes, and this is a Mercedes dash that I have wirelessly on my phone. So, all right, we are cranked up. Make sure my volume is where I can actually hear it. All right. So a little bit about what we're doing at the moment. I've got a job I'm going to go pick up, and because I'm driving my own truck, I have to go get it. You're not placed right where the job is, so we're gonna go get it. So we got a little drive to where it is at. Right now, we do not have anything on the back of our truck, but we're gonna go pick it up. And I can't remember exactly what the load was going to be. I know I just picked it because I believe we get to go across some water, take a ferry, which I haven't done yet. That'll be a new experience. I don't know if you actually get to see. Probably not. That's probably wishful thinking. I don't know if you get to see what's going on the ferry, or if you just sleep, because in this game you do have to rest, so I'm assuming it'll just be some rest. And that'll be fine too. But I just think that it's cool that you get to cross the pond. So this game, you get penalized for not following the rule. You get penalized for speeding too often. You get penalized for damage and different things like that. Actually, it is getting a little bit dark out. Yeah, 22. Yeah, 22:11. Let's go ahead and put some lights on. You get penalized for that too. But I have to say, the graphics on this game are pretty good. I like them. I think I've pretty much got a maxed out spanning. Hey, there's an airport over there. Maxed out spanning across all of my monitors, and it seems to run pretty smooth. Every once in a while, I get a little frame rate hiccup. They're playing up there. But other than that, it seems to work pretty good. And I have really been enjoying this game. That's why I've been playing it so much. It's been a lot of fun. It's probably, honest to God, one of the most addicting games, believe it or not, that I have ever played. It's just the way they have it designed and stuff. It just wants, it just makes you want to keep playing. It's really, really cool. you don't get the adrenaline rush like you do sim racing door to door, but that's, you know, that's a different game. I mean, this is a different thing. I like this because you can just relax, cruise, and enjoy the scenery. And they do a really good job. I mean, these are real world locations. You're driving from one real world to another city, real world. So that's, you know, a real world city location to another one. The distance is a little shorter and the time is a little shorter, but that's because no one has freaking days of their life to do this and not get paid for it. But I think the amount of time it actually takes you to get somewhere is actually perfect. It's not too long, it's not too little. And depending on what jobs you take, I mean, it's, some of these still do take a long time. I did one earlier today that took at least 30 minutes of real world time for me to complete. I am running this game through my gated shifter. This is a 12 speed manual transmission, but I've got a button mapped. They're split gear, so I've got my odd, you know, 1-3, so on and so forth, mapped to one button. And and the evens mapped to another. So typically, if I'm not pulling a load, I just keep it on one and just, you know, do like you actually would in a real truck and just... I gotta get over, buddy. Speeding offense. Ain't that some shit? I think I'm supposed to turn here, yep. So it's very easy to get a speeding offense in this game. And I upgraded my truck, so I'm not used to that it has a lot more power than the last truck I had. So I'm not really paying attention to how fast I'm going. And they take a ton of money out. Just lost, I think, $550 on that. We're going to be pulling into this right here. Sand Builders is what it's called. All right, we'll stop right here. Forgive me if I look down at my keyboard. It's just because it's asking me to hit a button. And if the camera, if my glasses lose focus, I do apologize. I'll just pull it up here. There we go. I think we were going to do this bad right here. It's got... let's see, 11,000, and I've got offer expires in 14 minutes. I can go by Friday, and I think, pretty sure that is the one. Yeah, by Friday, so that we have plenty of time to deliver. We're going to take the job. All right, there it is right there. Looks like a backhoe or something. Looks like it might have rained here recently. There's a lot of mud in this yard. I wonder if that's going to give us traction problems. Probably. This is a single rear axle truck. Can't afford to get the big boys yet, but this is an upgrade from what I had. I had a ragged, I don't even know, I don't recognize a lot of the brands. You know, I don't recognize a lot of these overseas truck brands. So I don't know what it was, I can't even remember, but it is now a backup spare, and I've actually got another employee using it. All right, we're ready. Just up here so I can find T. Okay, we are hooked up. So now I believe we're gonna go drive over to the ferry, hop on the ferry, skip over some water, and then drop this thing off somewhere, and hopefully this will be a success. I'll just kind of chat my way here and there as we're going. You do get penalized for any damage that you do to the trailer or the equipment that you're moving. And it's not always equipment, it's all kind of different stuff. Just in this case, it happens to be equipment. There are two ways to run jobs in this game. And please forgive me, but I need to see, make sure. When I've got the equipment, I'm very, very careful that I don't pull out in front of anybody. But yeah, you have to be careful that you don't hit, you know, anything. The railings on the side of the road. This seems to be a long trailer. What length is this trailer? Yeah, oh, it's only an 8-foot trailer. It looks a lot longer out the window there. Forgive me, I'm just being a little bit careful at the moment. there's no traffic over there. I'm not sure if that's supposed to be fog on that window over there or what, but every once in a while I see it, and it kind of blurs my view. I'm not sure what that is, but... Oh yeah, come on, turn right out in front of me. The AI in this game are very strange. They work okay, but they make some interesting choices sometimes. I had one run square into the back of a load I had the other day, and I don't know why in hell he did that. Man, I didn't pull out in front of him or anything like that. All right, let's see here. All the speeds, because we're overseas, these are kilometers per hour. So is my speedometer here. So we are looking at 80 kilometers an hour, and I'm running about 74. Like I said, I like to take it safe. This isn't a game. You do have a limit on time that you have to drop your load off, but you're better off going slow and relaxing, which is cool because you get to take in the scenery and stuff. And there's weather. Sometimes it'll rain, things like that. I am very much so looking forward to the American Truck Simulator, though, because break in this corner. I hear trailers do tip over. Because I'll actually recognize the scenery that I'm passing by, you know. I've never been to Europe, so I know some of these buildings and stuff look pretty cool and pretty fancy, but I don't know what they are for the most part. So in the American Truck Simulator, a lot of traffic behind us back there. In the American Truck Simulator, it will be better because I'll recognize some of it, you know. Yeah, and I think we are heading over to the ferry. So this will be interesting to see. If I had to guess, let me make sure my trailer doesn't hit anything back there. If I had to guess, I would say that we won't see the ride on the ferry. We will just... probably skip over the water, and the time will change. Is this one supposed to pull in? Yeah, okay. Here. Just going slow, because I don't think I've been in this ferry before. I've been doing this for about a week now, and I've only uncovered about 10% of the roads, and I don't have any DLC yet at all, so it's a big ass map. Huge map. Steps. Alright, this is weird. I'm gonna pull up here because this is where it's saying to go. Okay, so hit enter. Travel. And it is giving us some options here. 960 and 9. That goes there. Ooh, okay, so, well, shit, you know what? I don't remember which way we're supposed to go. I didn't know I was going to have a choice. So we're either going to have a short journey when we get to the other country over here, or a long journey. Well, let's just try this one. Embark. Here we go. Yeah, so it's a loading screen, so that's what I assumed. It's probably going to drop us off. Yep. Oop, here we go. And it is raining, so... to view possible travel, we don't need to do that because we're on the way out. So let me get my map up. Okay. So we got another 4 hours to get where we're needing to go. Obviously, that won't be true 4 hours, but it will take a little while, probably 15 minutes or so. And... we've got 18 hours and 34 minutes to get there, so we're plenty good on time. And yeah, okay, so we're plenty good on time. It is raining. Let's turn some wipers on. I do think the rain effect in this sim is on point. It is really, really good. And I need to get me back where I was. Sometimes it's strange, the interior camera moves itself around, and it's hard to get it back where I wanted it. All right, so, forgive me, I'm gonna itch my eye. And that's where my camera is on my face, their glasses. So here we go. Didn't see any traffic, so we're gonna start this journey. Oh boy, okay. I almost jacked up right there. Apparently I'm on the other side of the road now, which is quite confusing. Oh, I got a green light. Yeah, that, I could have really fucked up there.
Wow.
Alright, so this says speed cameras, so let's make sure we don't speed. 48 kilometers an hour is what we're allowed. We're going to stick to that. We want to be safe anyways. I may even go a little slower, we'll see. And I don't know if it's the rain or what, but I am getting some stutter for some reason right now. I don't know why. It's weird, but hopefully that'll clear itself up, because that's the first time that this has happened. It's a little bit annoying. Yeah, might just be because there's a lot of AI cars and rain all at the same time, probably. Oh, around a boat. Run the boat. Oh shit, I pulled out in front of somebody. Yeah, I do have the graphics maxed. I don't want to, but I may have to turn some of them down. That is so weird. I wonder why it's stuttering like that. I think we may be good now. Might be just in those heavy city areas. Alright, what's our... Oop, I'm speeding. I better slow down. Oh, yeah, it just went up to 97, so now we can pick it up. All right, so we got a good long drive, so I can just chat. And hopefully I won't bore you. Like I said, let me know in the comments if this is something that you guys would like to see, because I definitely plan on... Wrong way of fence. Fuck! I'm on the wrong side of the road again! God darn it. Shit. Losing more money on this trip than I'm making. Jesus, I gotta remember. Stay on the left, dumbass. Stay on the left. Okay. When American Truck Simulator comes out, I do plan on playing that a lot and really concentrating on, you know, not just doing the loads, but the idea of this game, and I'm sure it'll be the same in American Truck Simulator, is to really build an empire. Build a company, buy a lot of garages, get some folks working for you, and actually hire them out to deliver for you and to make a ton of money and buy newer trucks, customize your trucks. It's amazing. And I know that I'm not going to speed limit, but I'm going to go slower just because I've got plenty of time and it's raining, and that's a heavy load behind me, so that's why, if you're wondering. But yeah, so are our lights on? Yeah, our lights are still on. Just turn here. Here we go. So anyway, so yeah, so long story short, I probably will do some quote-unquote Let's Plays, or I might just video and talk while I'm doing some of my missions on that game as well. So give me some feedback. Let me know if y'all like this kind of stuff. If you do, I'll definitely do it. If not, I don't want to waste my time, so I won't. And that's just the long and short of it. I enjoy making videos like this, so hopefully y'all will like it pretty good. But when I started out in this game, obviously I was brand new. I'd never played this game. And when you start out, it's just like in real life. You have a truck driving license, and you get hired out by other companies, and you drive their trucks. They pay for fuel. It's raining like a mother. They pay for fuel. You don't have to worry about any maintenance or anything. You just click on what job you want to take. You get paid the amount of money it is. Obviously, you don't get paid as much. And you do just a bunch of jobs. And about the fourth or fifth job in, a bank sent me an email and told me that they were willing to give me a €100,000 loan to purchase whatever I wanted to purchase, trucks maybe, or whatever, you know. And I opted out of that at first, to be honest. I said, you know what, let me just do some missions, because I was making $3,000, $4,000, or $5,000 a mission, and I had my eyes set on a truck, which I can't even remember the brand of it now, because it was, you know, beginning of the week last week, and it was about a $90,000 truck. So I said, you know what, I'll just save up. And I did that for a little while. I think I got up to about, I did enough missions where I got to probably 65,000-70,000, and the bank came back and then said they would now offer me 500,000. euros, and I was like, fuck, that's too much, but I will take a little bit. So I took a $200,000 loan out. I purchased the truck I wanted. And it was a very, very baseline truck, no power, no anything. And I started doing some missions with my own truck. And how that works is you go to the same place to find jobs, but once you pick the job that you want, whatever part of the world you're in, you have to drive to go get the load. You load up the load, you take it where it's going, you drop it off, and then that completes the load, or it completes the mission, which I kind of enjoy that better. And also you get paid more, which is also a plus. However, you have to do all the maintenance on your truck. Be careful, I don't sideswipe anybody here. This is a wide ass trailer behind me. You do all the maintenance on your truck. You have to put fuel in your truck. Because you're driving a lot longer distances to go pick up the loads and things like that, you have to rest. So it becomes a strategy game. So that's the best of both worlds for me. I've got a strategy game and a driving game, and I really enjoy that. And those two things together make it just a freaking epic experience. And anybody who hasn't played this, even if you're not running on a crazy triple monitor setup like this, I still think it would be fun on a single monitor. Dealing with all the weather and the night, the day cycles, and trying to plan your trips. I gotta get out of this lane. Trying to plan your trips so that you don't accidentally have to rest, and then you run out of time for to deliver your item, because then you get less money if you don't get there in time. So it's pretty cool. And not to mention, the map is freaking expansive. I think I mentioned that before, but the map is massive. Been playing this pretty damn solid. I've got at least 15 hours, if not more, in this game in the last week. And I think I've only covered about 10% of the roads, maybe 12%, something like that. I saw it earlier. Yeah, this is like a cool... What's up, bus? What you doing slowing down for? You know something I don't know? Oh, yeah, I'm speeding. Oh, shit. And something else that I noticed, or I realized very quickly, is you get into construction zones, and my GPS up here says the speed limit's 80, but on the side of the road, if you'll notice, it says 50 in the construction zones. And almost every time I came through one of these, I got ticketed every single freaking time. So I've been more cautious about things like that. Now, you can speed if you're behind on a load in certain areas. I've noticed out in the country where there would be less cops and things like that, you can push a lot harder, and you won't get caught. I've gone pretty long spans of speeding very fast and not gotten a ticket, but it just really depends on where you are, I think. I guess we're going towards Birmingham here. Just get on over. Say it rains all the time out here. Apparently in this game, they're not lying. We're going to do a loop, and we are going to be on the M1. So their highway systems are, we're going to be down there. Their highway systems are quite a bit different than we have in the States. And it's cool. I mean, I like learning about stuff like that, but I am ready to be on some American highways. So I'm super excited about American Truck Simulator. I know I've mentioned that, but I can't say that enough. It's going to be so much fun. I think the rain is starting to slow up, which is going to be great. Yep.
Sweet.
So we can lose the wipers. Yeah. Great. It's cool because they even add like a wet haze to the windshield. I don't know if you guys, can see that. I put in the wrong gear, but it's very cool. Very cool. They have a lot of detail in this game. Not to mention all the scenery and stuff. See this little guy right here. He is, when that turns completely blue, I mean, then you're out of time. You've got to sleep when that gets close to blue, or else video will actually start turning black, like you're getting tired, and that's dangerous because obviously you can destroy a load.
You got your fuel here. Of course, I've got all that information down here on my gauges as well. And in case you're wondering, there is a full, I mean, there's a full cockpit in the truck and all that. You can see all around and stuff, but I want it to be realistic, so I keep my field of view where I think it would normally be. But this is as real as it gets as far as driving a truck. I don't drive trucks for a living. I've never driven a big rig truck like this, but I can imagine that it's pretty similar to this. To a point, just like sim racing is the same as real racing. I mean, I feel like they put a lot of effort into recreating what it would really be like. Now I'm switching over to my other gear set. Oh, shit. Yeah, so I can use 12th gear and save a little fuel to go on the highway. So the previous truck I had, shit, I shouldn't have done that. That was stupid. The previous truck that I had, I can't remember the brand. I still own it, but one of my drivers is driving it. It was a piece, and it was a 330 horsepower engine, and I don't know what the equivalent in torque is for us in the States, but it had X amount of torque, and it just didn't, see, look at that little jackass. It just didn't have enough torque. A lot of times if I was exiting a highway and going up an on-ramp, or I'm sorry, exiting a side road onto a highway, and you know how like the highway's up on a bridge, so you have to go up a steep up-ramp or on-ramp to get onto the highway. It just didn't have enough power. I was almost crawling to a stop. So when I purchased this truck, this is actually a Mercedes. Now, I didn't have a ton of money, so it's a bottom-of-the-line Mercedes. I purchased like a $98,000 Mercedes or 98,000 euro Mercedes. But I did upgrade the engine and transmission. So I've got about 450 horse and almost double the amount of torque that I had in my previous truck. And this one pulls things much easier. But, you know, the ladder of trucks, it goes even higher than that. You can get really, really powerful trucks. I think I saw one in the Mercedes dealership with like 700 horsepower. And I forget what the torque numbers were, but it was ridiculous. I bet you that can pull any shit in the game. Like it's no issue, you know. But there are virtual mirrors you can put up on the screen. I've turned all that stuff off, and I actually turn my head. You'll see me turning my head. I actually use the real mirrors like you would in a real truck. I think that's more realistic, so I like doing it that way. Well, it's a nice Jaguar over there to our left. I just think it's more realistic like that. If you use the mirrors the correct way, follow the rules of the road. So far, I haven't had any major mishaps. I haven't tipped a trailer. The only thing that had happened, like I said, was an idiot AI driver ran the hell into the back of me and tore the shit out of a load I had. I forget what it was. Trees, I think. Logs. It was lumber. So I'm sure it hurt him more than it hurt me, but it was a pain in the ass because I had traveled a long distance and I got like half of what the load was supposed to be because I had to pay for damages. And that was actually not even on my truck. That was on a truck that I was, you know, I had rented out for a job, so I had to pay for damages on the truck, the trailer, and the damn item. It was a waste of about 10 minutes of my life. So we started off with about 4 hours worth of journey. You see, we've been running for maybe 10 minutes now, maybe 15. I'm not even sure I've been paying attention, but we've only got 1 hour left, 63 kilometers left. So you can see how the time is sped up a little bit. Shit, we are going to miss our turn. All right, here we go. Thank you for letting me over, Dick. Actually, there's a bus back there that did slow down. You can see him. I appreciate that. Let me give you a little thank you there, buddy. Horn is pretty weak on the Mercedes, I must say. May actually put it into my odd gears. Because because it looks like we've got some curvy and possibly hilly roads ahead of us.
Go around this guy.
So if you're in your odd gears, you've got a little more torque to work with, or not a little more torque, but a lower gear ratio, you know, 1/3, 5th, 7th, 9th, and 11th, as opposed to 2nd, 4th. Look at that dumbass. 2nd, 4th, 6th, 8th, 10th, and 12th, they're a little bit of a higher gear ratio when you're going from one to the other. Now you can change it where your gears are in order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so on and so forth, but I prefer it this way because the gear ratios are just way too close together and there's no way I would use them all. It'd be a waste of time putting something together over there. I might speed it. The rain has stopped. I might pick us up a little bit as far as speed goes. I'm trying to think, before I started making this video, there were a couple of things I said to myself, you know, make sure you talk about this in this video, and fuck, I've carried on, and I don't think I talked about not one of them damn things. And I barely even remember what they were now. That's the thing about this game. I just get into driving, I get into zone, man, and I don't even think about anything else. Except for getting these things delivered, and I gotta turn. Oh boy. Not paying attention to my GPS. I'm going way too fast. Way too fast. Shit. So we're getting close to our destination. I'm gonna change my GPS here. I gotta get over, so you're gonna have to just bear with it. Don't you hit me. Yeah, he almost hit me back there, but that technically may have been my fault. So I know most people that do these videos direct screen capture, but I don't want to do that because y'all will get like a single screen view. I like doing it like this. Give me some feedback on that, guys. Do you like these? These are point of view sunglasses, and I've taken the lens out of them, and they're 1080p glasses that record my exact point of view. The camera is right in between my eyes, so you guys see exactly what I see. Birmingham discovered. I've not ever been here apparently. And I think if I was watching a video, that's what I would prefer. So that's just how I base that, you know, because you actually are seeing in the cabin as I turn my head. I think that would be what I would prefer in a video or whatever. So, you know, just let me know though if that makes you sick or whatever. I know people have said that might make people sick, but whatever. This is what I prefer. I think this is the coolest. But we're here. Like I said, I'm not a truck driver. I'm not the best at backing up. And, of course, this happens to be one of the locations with an extremely difficult place to back to. So this may be quite humorous for you guys to watch me try to unload this. But at least it's during the day. So I can see a little better in my mirrors. We have to actually back it around. I hope I don't fail. If I fail miserably at this, I do apologize, guys. All right, here we go. And I'm not going to cheat. I know a lot of people will look outside, like I'll show you. If you take your mouse and you turn, it actually looks out the window or whatever. I ain't going to do that shit. I like it to be what it would be like if I was in this bitch trying to really back this thing. I couldn't stick my head way out that window. So we're going to try put this thing in the spot. Now, I did work for a equipment rental company years ago that I did have to back trailers a lot, but they were not to the extent or size of this. So it is much different. Yeah, and I'm failing at this. This may take a few tries. To skip parking the trailer and complete the delivery. I should do that because this is going to be a bitch, but I'm not going to. I just keep right on talking until I get this motherfucker in this hole. That's what we're going to do. I hope I don't hit anything, though. And I know I'm missing it, but we're going to... Actually, fuck, is that it right there? Fucking A, man. I'm going to tell y'all now, straight up, that was luck that I got it close to it. I think I'm gonna hit that other trailer. Fuck, I hope I don't hit that trailer. I'm actually much closer than what I thought I would be though. Fucking A, man. Bear with me. I'm actually a little bit excited that I've got this anywhere near where I was supposed to put it. I'd have to straighten it up one more time, but that's all right. Because this is a bitch of a place. I'm not even going to lie. This is a tough place to get your trailer into. So now we'll wrap around and start using this other mirror over here. Oh, fuck, I wish I could see. I think I'm close though, man. Well, we're gonna straighten. Nope, I bumped right there. Sorry. So let's just straighten her up one more time. Fuck, come on, man. Don't make me look stupid. I'm trying like hell to do this shit. God damn it. Pardon my language. I really want to get this in this fucking hole. I'm close, man. I'm so close. Oh, y'all are probably laughing your asses off. I know it. That's okay. Fucker. So if you don't come back and watch for anything else, come back to watch me make a fool out of myself parking a fucking trailer. Because that is humorous. All right, there we go. I think we might get her in there. I'm a little bit crooked. Please be enough. Please be enough. I'm so close. I'm just off-centered, I think. Yep. Oh my goodness. Y'all don't understand how excited that makes me. It's not perfect. It ain't straight. But it's fucking in there. And I've got this message saying cargo is ready for unloading, so I get my points for unloading. Anyways, I enjoy y'all taking a ride with me. Really, let me know. Give me some feedback. If you happen to watch all the way through this, which I hope you do, give me some feedback. Do you like these? As I do, you know, more and more of this, I'll learn the ropes of this game. And I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to start American Truck Simulator from scratch and run it through and try to build just a diverse trucking company with a ton of trucks and a ton of people working and a ton of shops and stuff. So if you think you might enjoy these and the commentary or whatever, let me know so that I know I'm not wasting my time if it's something you do or you don't want to see. So I appreciate you guys watching. I will see you for the next video. It may be a sim racing video. It may be a help video, maybe a tutorial, or it may be a video in this game, and it probably will be, to be honest, because this is what I've been enjoying playing the most lately. So my phone is dying. That means my gauges are dead. That means I'm dead. So I appreciate you guys sticking around for this entire video. I'll see you in the next one.